A worn-through coil wrapper was shorting 70-volt coil power to the bracketry and to the switch. Here you can see that switch 11 is on, even though I have the MPU switch matrix connectors taken off. This can only happen if the 4N25 on the power driver board is blown. This WPC MPU board is being driven with the WPC DMD ROM, and it has a switch column issue. So I'm going to show you with my logic probe on the ULN2803 what happens as I go pin to pin. That is normal there. That's pulsing, and it's driving the column driver to ground. And the way the switch matrix works is if the receiving side of the circuitry detects that ground, then it knows that the switch is closed. Clive's got a great write-up on that on his website. So I'm going across each of these pins. This is pin, the third one over, the second one over, and here's column one, and you can see that that is not pulsing. We can go down here to the pin also and see that it's not pulsing. Here's pin two. So this 2803 is blown. This came from an Adams family, and I'll roll in a picture of how this thing got blown. Let's do a very quick tour of my WPC bench. So the first thing is that to notice is that the boards aren't quite laid out the same spacing as in the WPC back box. So you need to make the, if you're going to do this, you need to make the ribbons longer to stretch from board to board. And the other thing that I like to do is put the dual row headers on in a way, so like this one, it comes up to the board and then it flips under the board. And I made it do the same thing here to go underneath the soundboard, and this will accommodate both the pre-DCS and the DCS soundboard, and then over to the DMD controller. With power distribution, you can make one giant harness, or you can do something like I've done here. This is ground 5 and 12. Always use the same colors, black, red, and green. And then I could just tee off of that bus and connect to each of the power headers as necessary. Same thing up here. Hope that helps. Well, we still have a problem. The output of this 2803 is still not pulsing. And now we can see that the input is not pulsing. So we've got a nice diagram in the Pin Wiki created by Sashka Vakul. I'm sure I'm butchering that, but I can see that, you see the pink one in the upper right-hand corner of the ULN2803? That maps back to the switch column 74, LS374, the pink one, so that's pin 9. And it happens that on this particular chip, pin 8 should be reflected in pin 9. So pin 8 is pulsing. That's the data bus, but pin 9 is not. I can show you on a couple other legs of it too that are pulsing correctly. So unfortunately, it's back to the bench again to cleanly remove U14, install a socket, and I'll be right back. And we are back, and as you can see, that last pin, which is pin 18, is pulsing, just like 17, 16, etc. But let's put it into switch test. And go across the diagonal of the switches. So like I mentioned, let's see, column 1, row 2, we need to do that also, sorry. Because on this board, this is in an Adams family, remember, which is a Fliptronics 1 game, which means that it's the same as a pre-Fliptronics. These two 4N25 optocouplers are the things that sense when a flipper has been closed. It senses the 70 volt power and transfers that to the switch matrix via the optocouplers that are inside of that tiny package. So we've got all the switches working properly now. Let me test the other coin door switches. Yeah, so that's all working just fine. Now this driver board, I need to test the rest of it, so why don't we do that? And again, I have the WPC DMD test ROM running. Awesome. Let's do GI test. And that's going to be working. I've done this a million times, so I know that each of those strings is working correctly. And we can do lamps and flashers at the same time. As soon as I press the buttons correctly. There we go. Looking good. So driver board is now good to go. I gave it the regular rehab power headers. The GI headers on this one were just fine, but I did the power headers. And I replaced C5, of course, C4 and C2, and of course the 4N25 opto coupler. So both MPU and driver board are good to go. The failure of the driver board was a 70 volt coil had worn through its coil wrapper, and I put a picture of this in, and shorted the switch matrix, and it blew the U20, and then it went further upstream and blew U14. Now this is the ULN2803 that I've got in the switch test, or my Chinese tester, and it says it's good. Wait a minute, which one is that? Let me test that again. Interesting. And here is the, sorry, I need three hands to do this. Here's the 374 that I took out, and it's definitely got a problem. Now where? Yeah, that was the 2803 I took out of there. Very strange. I dropped it on the ground. You can't drop an IC without bending a pin. But that's definitely the one I took out of there. I don't know how it would have hopped around the 2803 and gotten up to the 374, but that's what it looked like it did. Good to go now, though. Thank